Games You Missed is a series where I highlight a great game that may have escaped your notice. If you have any suggestions for games you'd like to see featured in this series, let me know in the comments section. But today, we're going to be talking about ReCore. ReCore was one of maybe three games I was ever looking forward to on the Xbox One, before Scalebound was cancelled and pretty much every Xbox game also became available on PC. Now my Xbox One just sits around and continues to collect dust, but I did in fact play ReCore on PC. Before we jump into the game though, I am talking about ReCore Definitive Edition here. I never picked up ReCore when it first launched, which is lucky because apparently it was more than a little rough around the edges. Plagued with long loading times, performance issues, and a general lack of things to do, but I have to say I have experienced none of that in the Definitive Edition. I actually bought this on sale about 6 months ago, but didn't start playing until more recently, and I was really surprised. I expected a bad to mediocre third-person shooter, but I actually got a pretty damn good third-person hybrid platformer shooter with a kind of Metroidvania gameplay element, and on top of that, a pretty damn compelling story too. Now that is a lot of genres to cram into one game, especially a game with what I'm led to believe isn't the biggest budget in the world, and that is possibly the game's biggest negative. It has an identity crisis at times. It isn't sure what it wants to be. It hasn't stopped me really enjoying it and all the different elements, but it would have been a stronger game if they cut something to focus on the other somethings. That said, it didn't stop ReCore from being a good game, and a game that is worth your time. You begin in what looks like a large open map, but you'll find yourself being ferried in a linear direction towards a sort of cave. This opening section does a good job of explaining the different game mechanics, it teaches you the basics of combat, the way you can move throughout the world, and hits you with some very basic platforming to introduce the double jump and dash mechanics. Inside the cave, you get better acquainted with combat, and are introduced to some of the mechanics that your trusty robot puppy sidekick possesses. You'll have your first boss fight, after which you'll receive something that you'll see a hell of a lot of throughout the game, a power core, and after that you are essentially let loose into the world. The game has this illusion that it's a vast open world ripe for exploration, but the world is less Skyrim and Fallout and more Zelda Wind Waker. See, the world itself isn't that interesting. It is beautiful, but it's not filled with super special secrets and really great discoveries. It's more of a platform to lay the more interesting and focused experiences of dungeons on top of. You'll move from dungeon to dungeon, unlocking power cores that allow you to enter new areas and new dungeons. You can tackle challenges whenever you want to as long as you meet the requirements, namely level and number of power cores. So the game gets more and more freeform as you progress. There are tons and tons of collectibles just about everywhere because your robot companions need upgrades, and those upgrades are fueled by items and collectibles that both the open map and dungeons are littered with. The dungeons are really where ReCore's strengths are though. It's better as a more linear experience that the game guides you through. It tells its story better that way, and the whole game just feels more interesting. The design is just at odds with being plopped into a vast open map where there is very little to do besides find new dungeons. It can sometimes feel a little repetitive, and the combat is repetitive, but then again, there is only so much you can do for combat in a third-person shooter, and there are plenty of elements here. You can continue to unlock mechanics as you play, as well as new companions for you to customize. The story in the world is really interesting, the companions are fun to customize, and the dungeons are really well done. And had ReCore focused on these elements and made it a shorter, more linear experience, this game would have been off the chain. As it stands today though, ReCore Definitive Edition is definitely worth your time if any of this sounds good to you, especially at the prices you can get it for nowadays. It's a shame Microsoft really dropped the ball of support and promotion, but then again, this isn't Forza 982 or some dude bro shooter, so that might have been asking a bit too much for Microsoft. And speaking of asking for too much, if you wouldn't awfully mind hitting the like button, that would be awesome. You can also join the conversation in the comment section, follow me on social media, and check out links in the video description to find out how you can support the channel. Have a good day or night, and I'll see you all soon.